guys, welcome back to my channel. So today we are going to create a bot in Teams. So for that you have to go over here, search for Power Virtual Agent. After that, add Power Virtual Agent to Teams. Once it's added, you can start creating the chatbot. And you need to select a theme for which this chatbot will work. So I'll just select my theme for demo. I'll continue. So you can give a name for your chatbot. Let's call it Jimmy. Let's create one. There you go. So this is the chatbot screen that you get. If you go to topics, it will show you some predefined topics that it has, like greetings, goodbye, thank you, and you can directly start from here. You can test this. You can say good morning. Good morning. So it kind of works like that. So you can also create a new topic, and let's call it, maybe we can talk about WFH and leave. And trigger can be leave, work from home, rest, and whatever you want. Click on go to authoring canvas to configure this option. So when this trigger phase is shows up, you can rather than showing a message, we can ask a question. Maybe options can be take a leave. Work from home. And then it can, so this is the option for WFH, and this is the option for work from home, which is auto populated. So if you want to take a leave, it may ask you further question. What is the reason for your leave? And it can be just so there are different options. You can take entire response and save it over here, and you can ask questions like for which date you want to take leave. You can then check for date probably, and you can also ask a question like, please enter the email of your supervisor so that it can send out an email to supervisor. Then finally a message saying we have sent your request to supervisor. And just before that, we can also call a condition. So this will create a flow that will send an email to the supervisor. So also these variable names, we can use it or pass it to the flow for it to receive and send the email. So let's rename these. So let's call it var email, call it var date, and maybe var region. Now let's create a flow that sends out an email to supervisor. Let's save this. So let's create a flow There are various templates that you can select from. I select this one. So let's call it send an email to supervisor. And then we can input values like reason. Then I can take input values like date, and then email, and then I can send an email using flow. Sorry, email. I can also take the name of sender. So see more sender has let's call it employee. Let's there's a question for me. Here I can put email here as requested leave on date because of following reason, and the reason goes here. Save it. You can also create an approval flow for if you want to do approval system, but let's I'm just keeping it basic over here. So let's go back. And let's configure here. It's called an action. The flow will appear here. So and now I need to pass values. So reason will be Y reason. Date would be this date, email would be this email, and employee would be user display. Save it. You can do the same thing from work from home branch. Right now I'll just do it for leave. So let's see, I want to take rest. So take a leave or work from home. I want to take a leave. So what is the reason for your leave? I worked much yesterday from which date you want to take leave. Let's put 17 2020, and email of your supervisor. I'll just put my email for now. And done. I think email has come. Let's check the flow if it has ran or not. So let's click here. Yeah, I got the email. So that was it, guys. I hope you have liked this video. If you like this, please subscribe to my channel, and please click the bell notification to stay updated with all kinds of content like this. Thank you so much.